The word diet has become a very common thing. Most of us are on a diet for several reasons, mainly for weight loss or sometimes to make your general lifestyle a little bit more healthy. But why do diets fail? Most of the times diets fail because they're very restrictive. So when diets become restrictive, socializing becomes a problem and it starts interfering with your day-to-day life. So this becomes a problem for you to stick to a particular diet. For example, all of us like to eat out once in a while. Although home-cooked meals are the best as far as your health goes, on special occasions, we all like to eat out. So how do you fit eating out into your diet plan? So this is something which has been very commonly asked, and here are a few guidelines for you to follow while eating out. So the first thing for you to do is to select the right restaurant. How can you do this? These days, technology is available. You can always Google or get onto any of the food apps for you to look at the menu of a particular restaurant. So if you are prepared upfront and if you pick the right restaurant, which has certain food choices that you would like to incorporate into your diet, it becomes easier for you to stick to your diet. Second thing is, once you reach the restaurant, the food that you pick from the menu has to be done very carefully. Let's, for example, say you want to select a soup. So when you pick a soup, stick to soups which are clear. In the sense, you might be thinking that if you have a soup, it might be very healthy, but there are soups which are loaded with calories. For example, the chowder type of soups are very, very high calorie and very dense. So always pick soups which are clear, either based with vegetables or with protein. So pick clear soups. Second thing is when you select your salads. That's another area where we all go wrong. So when we select salads, we think we are doing the right thing and we pick a healthy choice. But salads can be very deceptively heavy in calories if you mix the dressings along with it. So pick a salad and always let your waiter know that you would like the dressing on the side. This way, when you have the dressing on the side, you can select a small amount of dressing to be added to your salad, which will limit the amount of calories. Next is selecting the main course. So when you select the main course, always look out for dishes with, say, grilled, baked, braised, or boiled. So these forms of cooking utilize very minimal amount of oil and will reduce your calorie intake. So avoid things that are fried or breaded and crumb fried. So these become very, very high in calories. Last thing is your dessert. Now we all love desserts, and it is sometimes difficult to avoid having desserts, but unless it's a special occasion, try to avoid the dessert part of your diet. The last thing is, how do you select how much of protein, how much of carb, and how much of fat you need to consume when you select a meal at a restaurant? So if you are at home, some of you may be in the habit of weighing your food out, which is the best way for you to stick to your calories if you are on a weight loss journey. So when you eat out, you can stick to what we call as the palm, fist, and thumb rule. So when you select a main course, the amount of protein that needs to be on the plate should be about the size of your palm. The amount of carbohydrate that should be on your plate should be the amount of your fist, and the amount of fat that needs to be in your plate should be the size of your thumb. So when you select your protein, stick to lean sources like fish and chicken breast, which are the most lean kind of proteins that you can get in the non-vegetarian sources. As far as the vegetarian sources go, you can stick to soya, tempeh, edamame, etc. So these will fulfill your protein requirements. When you select your carbs, again, choose very wisely. You can have a side of steamed rice or you can have a side of potatoes. Now, when you select potatoes, you have a wide choice. You might think mashed potato is a very good choice, but mashed potato, again, you do not know how much of fat is added to it. So always stick to a boiled kind of potato, which comes along with the jacket. So these will be a better choice compared to going in for fries or bread, etc. So you can go in for steamed rice or you can go in for boiled or steamed potatoes. So these will be a good choice. Most often in restaurants, the amount of oil that they use is already quite high in your dishes. So try to avoid the fat part of your plate. So these are the general guidelines that you can use when you are eating out for you to actually stick to your diet and be on a moderate calorie diet when you eat out. Thank you, friends.